Hello everybody. Today I'd like to show you a little portable space heater I made. And you know, I didn't really like the clay pot and candle heater idea. The wax melted. I didn't like the toilet paper in a quart paint can with alcohol idea because it was just dangerous. I needed to come up with something for myself, just something. I ended up with my favorite hot sauce bottle here. As you can see, there's a wick in it and fluid. This is the fluid I use. It's ultra pure lamp oil. Of course, I needed to get this thing back out, the wick back out. And sometimes it works easy, sometimes it doesn't. It's problematic, as with this whole thing. But as you can see, now I've got this stuck. But anyway, it goes back in there like that. Might want to wad up the end a little so it stays. And so that was my heating element, my burner unit. I thought that was kind of slick, but what do I do now? So I still had that quart paint can lid, can, and I ended up finding out that I can put five of those burners in a quart paint can. I cut out these notches for ventilation, trying to keep the fluid cool while burning. Don't want to overheat the fluid. I also cut out the lid. I wanted a shield to radiate the heat away from my fluid. I thought that was pretty neat, but still, we have an issue. It's kind of dangerous still. I ended up getting a 1 gallon paint can. I bonded a pan onto the bottom support, cut out more cooling ventilation. I also installed, as you can see, these screws here. They're spacer screws that keep the quart can in somewhat in the center of this unit. This is all a lot of fun. I have a few accessories. There's a couple screws, a screwdriver, some matches. I use this to put out the flames with. And I use this also to light. I'll show you more in a minute, but now that I was here, what was I going to do? Just leave this open? Well, I guess I could have. Still a little unsafe. I ended up finding a draining colander, and I cut a bunch of holes into it, drilled up from the previous holes here, and installed all these holes in this unit. I moved the handle and changed it like so. Just so happens that this colander fits in between the ears of the can here just about right. Thought that was neat. How was I going to keep it in place? I found some little screws. I don't like these too much. I have found something else, some thumb screws, but I haven't modified them yet to do this part of the trick. But This is the fun part here, trying to line up these holes right now. It might take me a minute. And where's my screwdriver? There it is. This is the tricky part. This is all a little problematic. And yet the results are great. I don't suggest anybody build this themselves. This works for me just fine, but it is fire and it is dangerous. And actually these cutouts are pretty darn sharp. So you could slice your finger in half by accidentally getting a hold of this. I would have liked to steampunk it a little, maybe get, you know, split a piece of 3/8 copper tube on one side and wrap it around the inside of this, but I haven't got there yet. Anyway, that's basically it as far as lighting it. That was also a little bit of a challenge, but like I said, I ended up with this thing here. I put a match at the end of this. Find my hole here. There it is. I light this. One, two, three, four, five. Make sure that's blown out. And then I can just put this back in place. And voila! Now, of course, you see me touching this handle right now, but believe me, once this thing gets hot, you don't want to touch it. You don't want to touch this handle once it's hot. The flames are peaking right now. They'll calm down a little bit in a little while. But let me show you. If I can, I've got a, let's see, what does it say? I've got a thermometer here, and I hope you can read that okay. What does it say? About 80 degrees, okay. I'm gonna put this here for a minute. Just above the heat source. It's climbing. It's already up to 180, 220, and it's just this. Oh, I mean, it's back at zero. As you can see, it's already gone well past 220 degrees. It's pumping out a lot of, it's real hot, right? Real, I mean, it's hot. It's finger shaking hot right there. It starts to get a little cooler about 2.5 feet above the unit. And otherwise, that's it. This is my little personal emergency heater. And it's, last weekend I went up to the mountains and camped out in my little Chevy Spark, and this thing kept the chill off. I only had two burners running, and it kept the chill off real nice in the car. I did crack the windows a little bit during the night, while I was sleeping. I was very confident that this unit would keep me warm and safe. Although I mentioned that this is fire, it's danger, and I wouldn't suggest anybody else building it, but it does work well for me. Now it's time to put out the flames. And that one. See, you can reduce the amount of flames you need also just by, well, it's a little warm here, so we'll just take one down. Or another one. And this is how I turn off my little space heater. It was a fun project for me. I was really excited that everything came together so well. I also built a 12 burner unit, and that one's really interesting. I built it out of baking pans and a wastebasket can. And that one is really fascinating. So if you thought this was interesting, why don't you like and subscribe? And I'll try and produce another video for the 12 burner. Also, if you have a comment, and if you do subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you again. This was Alex from the AmpTunes channel.